Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to play with the Leo tier 7 Swedish medium tank. The thing is, there was one person which was saying skill day 1, day 2, day 3, day 5, day 17, day 58, day 100 skill. And I hearted this person comment couple of times. I believe Kyler's can do quick fit imitate shooks try there and add the comments from this side, at least couple of them. And here you go, Leo it is. I want to show this tank with pretty much a couple of with couple of guns, because this tank has two useful guns, which is 7.5 centimeter gun and in the same time 10 centimeter gun. So pretty much what is the difference between those two guns? One gun has more alpha damage, another gun has a bit more DPM, and obviously it is way more accurate. So those are the two main differences. Anyways, enough of chatter, let's go into the battle and let's try to make this tank work. One more thing, I believe you noticed that we do not really have the most skilled crew, but that's completely understandable and we can't change absolutely anything about it. Don't mind me. Cheers. Okay, so what is the plan, what is the hope, and what is the dream? Once again, we are starting with a Minsk map, not the map which I know very, very well, so I am kind of confused playing there still, but we will make it work. At least I want to believe we will make it work. 5 heavy tanks, 4 mediums, 4 tank destroyers, 2 light tanks, no artists. That's actually good. You know what? I'm going to stick to the old strategies and chill in the middle. I think it is pretty damn good option for us. Also, one more thing which I want to highlight, by the way, I apologize for this start, it sometimes happens when I cannot stop yawning and I sincerely apologize, but I believe that was the last one, okay? So once again, I apologize for that. Okay. How are you doing today? Boom. That's completely fine. Even though if we would do the trades like this, we would feel extremely good because we would out DPM this guy, which is important thing to say. Keep this in mind, fellas. Either way, we would out DPM this guy. And now he's on the reload. That's it. Game over for this poor soul. Poor gentleman. It's time to go garage, my friend. It's time to go back home. Beautiful. Very, very nice. That was a quick farm for us. Probably he had no bloody clue what he is doing, speaking about his decisions. And once again, this is completely understandable. Good. Another EBR just died. Excellent. And what do we have? We have Fava, which is pushing through the middle. Good. I mean, so far, everything is looking pretty damn nice. Speaking about our performance and what enemies are doing, by saying it looks nice, I mean enemies are making shit ton of mistakes and a lot of stupidity. By the way, I believe you can notice the loadout which we have on this tank. And it's very, very important thing to say. So loadout which we are using is mainly gold. What is the main reason why we are having this loadout? Because this vehicle do not have that much ammunition. 50 shells times 150 alpha damage is like what? 7,500 potential damage, and it doesn't mean you are going to hit every single shot. Plus on top of that, if we are shooting like 3 minutes straight, it's GG. We do not have ammunition left and we are kind of screwed, effed and everything. So keep this in mind. This is very, very important thing to highlight. This is super important thing to highlight, fellas. Good, our EBR is just making a hardcore pressure for STG. STG is down to one shotable and STG is dead. Beautiful. This is exactly what we want to see, and this is how we want to play our game. Nice. And now we can be even more involved into all this, and the reason why we can be even more involved is simple. They do not have people in the middle anymore, and now if we are going to make a good scout run, we should be able to get a lot of, I repeat, a lot of use for ourselves. For example, this is assisting damage, and here we go, this poor soul is dead. Nice, this is exactly what we want to see. And now we want to get involved even more. Look at this, we are moving from bush to bush, from bush to bush. This is exactly how we want to do the things. And look at this, Jet Panther is spotted in the middle of the field. Now, if I will shoot this guy, more likely I am going to get spotted myself. So I'm not willing to shoot, but I'm willing to claim this free assisting damage, if that makes sense. Now, should we shoot this guy? Okay, we can shoot this guy, that's okay. And after that, we need to go into this ditch or dip here, right? It's a very important thing. We know about the bushwhacker, which could potentially be there. And if someone is sitting there, then we should be able to maybe spot him eventually. Anyway, speaking about the things, fellas, IS-3 is the lonely wolf, which we are going to slaughter. Or maybe I supposed to say sheep, which we are going to slaughter. He can't change absolutely anything about this, my friends. He was in the deep shithole and he kind of took one for the team. But once again, this is a typical World of Tanks battle nowadays, which is quite sad, but it is the case. When the game is not the most balanced, we are having 14-5 situation. But even though I am feeling semi-sleepy, I believe this is pretty damn strong performance for this tank, right? So we made the small PP work on this vehicle. I believe a lot of you or majority of you would agree with me in this situation. So what we are going to do, we are going to take a big boy alpha next. Twice more alpha, unfortunately we would have like 20% less DPM if I'm not mistaken, which is obviously not the best thing ever, but I think this is what we need to do. I should show both of the guns and both of the options, how you can make Leo work on how, or how you can do the things overall. So yeah, good, very very good. I believe the person which asked this tank for 100 days, I believe you are smiling now. At least you should, Mother Trucker. Oh, look at this, boys. Look at this. Ace Vanker, 2,200 damage, 2,100 assisting damage, great battle, 1.3 base experience. Obviously made quite a bit of profits because of the mission, but even without mission, we would be 27,000 up. And even though our loadout is definitely not the most budget friendly, there is a reason why we are having this loadout, because amount of ammunition is just simply very very poor on this tank. I think this tank should have at least 100 ammunition, so you can shoot, you can have 50 APs and 50 APCRs, but you know, it is how it is. Anyways, what we are going to do, we are going to get the other gun, and I am not a big fan of the other gun, just because how the gun is behaving overall. As you can see, loadout is also kind of the same, even though with this gun we have a bit more potential, speaking about making damage. In the same time, I believe there is a reason why we have the APCR, more APCRs. I think it is because of the shell velocity, if I'm not mistaken, and overall of the penetration. In other words, if we are going to get the tier 9 matchmaking, we should go with mainly APCRs in a way. Kharkov. Shit ton of the tank destroyers, but like shit ton of them. One light tank, MTV, which I need to kind of be afraid of, I guess. I guess I kind of need to be afraid of this guy. Okay, what is the plan? What is the hope? What is the dream? I guess the best case scenario and the best bet which we are having here is to simply go and play safe. Skill, what do you mean play safe? You asshole, how could you say something like this? I don't want to go there because MTV has a humongous camo. He's in platoon with Scorpion. Scorpion sits there. MTV sits there. I get spotted. I get cut by a half. This is not what we want to do. Instead of that, we can chill around this area, or alternatively, we can simply play in the city, which is extremely important thing to do. Also, one more thing. If enemy heavy tank will try to cross like this, we are smacking him in the face. Once again, I apologize, fellas. Don't blame me too much. I haven't drank my coffee yet. Ay. This is not what we are looking for, and this is not what we want, but yeah. You see, now you are seeing pretty much the main difference between this gun and between the 150 alpha damage gun. 150 alpha damage gun is beautiful because of the accuracy and because of the DPM. This gun though, it is better for trading. So for example, remember the situation when we saw a MX-13 57 in the last battle? Well, we would out trade this tank for sure with this gun. With previous gun, it is a bit more complicated. Oh, that's a nice blind shot, fellas. I need to give a credit for this guy. That was a beautiful, beautiful blind shot. Hi there. Boom. Very nice. This is exactly what we want to see. We want to kind of help this Mr. Blade Prince for obvious reasons. And yeah, the gun accuracy, as you can see yourself. Remember, we do not have a snapshot. We do not really have a smooth ride. So for us to hit the shots with this tank, we need to aim and we need to ask for blessing of the RNG, which is definitely not what we are looking for and definitely not what we want. Okay, this IS-2S is kind of waiting for us, and once again, I don't really want to be there anymore, because if I am peeking sideways, the IS-2S can smack me, okay? IS-2S is kind of trying to escape. Now we are smacking this guy in the face. Yo, papa, this gun handling. Yeah, look at this, fellas. It is very important thing to mention and to highlight itself. This tank gun is absolutely atrocious. Unfortunately, but that's the case, and this is how it works. So keep this in mind. We will definitely get out DPM'd by the Tiger P, but there is a big chance we are going to hit him once again, or maybe even to kill his friend. That would be even better option for us. Yeah, here you go. This is the big gun. I truly dislike this gun, fellas. I just dislike this gun. Not much what I can do about this. Overall, I just took one for the team. It's all right. What happened there pretty much? Obviously, the first battle was a bit more lucky speaking about the situation. But overall, fellas, okay, listen. Hear me out there. I think this gun can work and we will play one more battle with this gun. But the most important thing is you need to spam APCRs. I mean, if you are not shooting APCRs, you are... It's just not great. Obviously, unless you have like 4 or 3 skill crew and you have brother in arms, so your gun is becoming a bit more accurate and other things. Other than that, it's just no bueno. Anyways, it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. We are going to teleport into the other game and hopefully the things will work a bit better. So let's do this. And we are back. Yeah, that was a great game. 15-5. Who could ever expect that? Outrageous! Yeah, this is the current World of Tanks, fellas. Stop crying, kids. So, in the next game, I'm going to shoot more APCRs. I think more APCRs is going to make that... Oh my bananas. I thought I had a horrible game. Oi, 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 oi. Oh well, It is how it is. Greetings from for our Bled Prince. Atler Fighter, what's up? Greetings to you, buddy. I hope you are doing well. Because I saw you. You said high skill. I saw you. Okay, so what do we need to do, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen? We need to go for a next game and we need to prepare to bank someone. It is very, very, very important. Let's try to do this. Come on, game. We can make it happen. Ooh, Red Shire, winning spawn. No lie, okay, one lie tank. Tier 7 lie tank, doesn't matter. Okay, we are going to try to spot here, spotting, we will try to spot crossing heavy tanks. I think this is the best bet which we have, because for the south spawn, in my opinion, it is relatively easy to take this side down. So what we are going to do, we are going to do this. Obviously, alternative option would be to go somewhere there, but I don't really necessarily need to do this. And plus on top of that, we have Ferrari, which might try to counter enemy light tank, which could sit there. So we'll see. Either way, my main mission is to have someone here and shoot here. This is all we need. Oy, oy. Oy, oy, looking into our team setup. Oy, 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 oy. There is two chances and two options overall of this game. Either we are going to have extremely great time and our team will bang everyone like there is no tomorrow, or we are going to get banged ourselves and we will forget our name. Both of the options could be very, very possible, fellas, truly. Both of the options are very possible, especially this M6. Well, take this. Beautiful. 313 in the face. Absolutely amazing. This is what we want. Now look at this. After like 2 seconds or so, we are going to try to shoot him once again. He's unspotted. That means we are unspotted too. And he should appear right there. At least that's what I want to believe. Beautiful. Another shot in the face. This is extremely good situation for us. Truly. It is very nice. This M6 made a humongous mistake. And he in a way fed us quite a bit, which is good. Okay, time to get more involved. What I am asking for, our people to pre-aim there and to pre-aim there. There is a reason why am I asking this. Beautiful, the light tank is sitting here. Very, very nice. Scorpion is trying to escape and we have E25, which is chilling and not paying attention to the maximap. Beautiful shot into the E25. E25 is truly unhappy about this and no one can blame him. And he is Russia. Ooh, and he is dead. Exactly what we need. Very, very great start, fellas. Now, I'm going to escape from here just in case if this 50 TP is going like this. I need to be safe just in case, because if the 50 TP is going, then no one can help me. I can promise you that. If 50 TP is making pressure, we are kind of effed up. Okay, guard decided to be a bit more involved. That's great. Charioteer is more involved, and as you can see, 50 TP is kind of a pussy. That's good. This is exactly what we want to see. In this game, I want to have at least 3,000 to 4,000 combined as a bare minimum. It is very important. It is extremely important, my friends. So let's see. Scorpion. What is the chance Scorpion is sitting here? I was trying to go for a blind shot for obvious reasons. And I will try to blind fire the Scorpion once again. Like I would have something to lose. Okay, beautiful. Let's... Aha! This is the light tank. Roger that. I mean, there is a chance I would spot the Scorpion otherwise, but that's fine. Cool, light tank took one for the team. Now listen, how about if we would do some relocating things? Wait a second. Okay, let's load APCRs maybe. There is two options what is happening in my head, or two things. One thing is to go back for a base defense, and another option is to simply sit here and wait until the Scorpion G or the light tank will get spotted, or someone who would get spotted there. It is important thing to say, trying to go for a not fully aimed shot, but that was reaction problem, you know. It wasn't bad decision to sit here or something, it was problem of the reaction, but that's fine, well deserved. Anyways, 3-2-1 Russia. Oh my bananas. And remember the first battle when we cannot hit absolutely anything, and now we are smacking them and doing whatever flying if we want. This is absolutely amazing. That's very good. Okay, let's try to relocate a bit. Our goal will be to make a good crossfire for the P-43 Ter, which is sitting there, and obviously Progetto. So what we need to do, we need to take this corner, and we simply need to be patient. Patience is the key in the current World of Tanks, fellas. Patience is the key. Let's see how we can make it work. How about if we are knocking this tree down and this tree down? This is very, very important, and let's try to stay a bit to the right. And what do we have? So far we cannot see absolutely shit, but I'm going for a blind shot anyways, and this is definitely not a blind shot. That's quite sad we are losing this this battle, because the HP loss is already quite visible. 1,500, unfortunately, enemies are playing well. Well, unfortunately for us, and very, very good for the enemies. Enemies did a humongous thing, which is, in my opinion, the best thing what they could ever do, which is to have a safe defense parameter around this side, and simply try to secure as much of the map control here. Now, if our team is making pressure like this, those guys are flexible enough to beat the living crap out of our team. So this is very important thing to say. Very interesting. Good. At least it is not 15 to 5. I am pretty damn happy about this game. Progetto is getting closer. I need help. Which obviously makes sense. And what do you want me to do? Mr. Hellcat, what do you want me to do? The thing is, it is not so easy, fellas. And enemies are making their lead even bigger there. Once again, I believe this is unfortunately game over, but we will try to get as much use as we physically and possibly can. That's okay. In before, Charioteer is going to say, "You asshole, why you are not helping me?" By the way, P-43 Ter, Russia. Unfortunately, the shot wasn't very, very well aimed, so I can't complain about this. Next will be APCRs, but before that, now, oh, beautiful hit in the face, very, very nice. We are still not spotted, so I am kind of chilling. Challenger should be able to... I am not spotted, good. Challenger should be able to spot P-43 Ter. At least he should be able to, but we'll see, obviously. Okay, it is kind of time to relocate. The main reason why am I saying it is time to relocate, because this type 62 will get here, and after that I will get outspotted. If I will get outspotted, it is going to be pretty much game over. Even though, obviously, this is not the greatest option either way. That's fine, relax, take it easy, MX is banging me in the ass, that's fine, and there is a humongous chance he is going to hit us once again, because I'm still spotted, and by the way, I am very, very well aware that I'm getting spotted by the Type 62, but once again, their team is playing better. If their team is playing better, not much what we can change about this, even though we had a winning spawn, and this is important thing to highlight, I would say. Okay, doesn't matter, let's see. TL. No, TL, what you are going to do? I truly want to see this guy making as much pressure as he can like this. And if he is going to do that, we should be able to smack him. Progetto down to one shotable. Very, very nice. We should be able to, hopefully, okay. Now we see where TL is. Wow, that's a smart pressure by this guy. Very, very smart pressure by TL fellas. Extremely smart. Yeah, not much what we can change about this. Okay, let's try to aim for this guy. Beautiful 300 damage in the face. Very, very nice. Wait for it, 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 wait for it. Now. Beautiful. Another 300 in the face. He's kind of down to one shotable. And he is going down. Excellent. There is still chance to do something for enemies, which is sitting there, right? We still have a bit of the chance. Now, this is very important shot. We need to successfully hit this. Yeah, we needed successfully hit this. Shame. Oh well, we did as much as we physically and possibly could. Overall, this is not a horrible performance. Enemies played very, very well. If I need to bet who carried this game, I would say it is going to be 50 TP, which had a very nice save defense parameter or perimeter, however to spell this properly, there. That was completely fine. It's alright. So what he have done, he spotted people which is playing there and he obviously farmed them. Same goes for TL1 PC, very, very great play, save defense parameter or perimeter there and banging everyone which is trying to make pressure like this. Very, very smart. Honestly, nothing to give, nothing to take. Those two guys are responsible for this victory. And once again, there is nothing bad. You need to know how to lose in the World of Tanks. Anyways, I believe you noticed the difference between the guns, speaking about the first gun which I played and the second gun. For me, first gun is better option. I'm sorry, fellas, 150 alpha damage gun is for me the way to go and I'm having the best time with it. As you can see, those two guys are on top of the leaderboard, assisting damage, damage, assisting damage, damage. Both of them did an extraordinary job there by knowing which position to take and they simply banged absolutely everyone. So yeah, overall I am pretty damn happy with our performance, even though we pretty much broke even or made 5000 credits. It's not changing absolutely anything. This is still a great game in my humble opinion. And overall our performance with this tank is 2000 damage, 1000 assisting damage, and what do we have? We have like close to 3000 combined, which is a great score, and I think we made Leo work. Once again, I prefer 7.5 centimeters gun, but if you like 10 centimeters gun, there is nothing wrong about it. You can like whatever you are liking, right? So, fellas, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you had a great time, and skill is out for today. Peace.